And good afternoon, people. This is Dragon Knight Cole.
Hello, Tyler Neighbor.
We are here in sunny Talledega, Alabama for the Aaron's 499. Let's break down the starting lineup. Starting on pole in the new Xerox Ford is Willie Boulderquake. And then alongside, Nate Bell in the Home Depot Coca-Cola Bear Pontiac.
We have David Perry in the DeWalt Power Tools Ford and Michael Gregory in the Dodge Dealer's Dodge. Okay, who put these two together? Jonathan King in the Singular Wireless Chevrolet and
Betty Johnson in the STP Dodge. Looking forward to a lap one wreck with these two.
Josh Richards in the Interstate Batteries Hulk car.
We'll be alongside Jerry Paolucci in the M&M's Ford.
We have the Kodak Easy Share Systems Pontiac and Quentin Moore alongside Kyle Martins in the Low Chevrolet.
John Gambit busting out the Cornflakes car, the Cornflakes Chevrolet alongside Alex Bossinger in the Coors Light Dodge.
We have Gabriel Wanderley in the UPS Ford alongside Cole Deaver in the GM Goodrich Plus Chevrolet.
Last week's winner, Matthew Medev, will be in the Mobile 1 All-Tel Dodge. Zach McVay in the Napa Nilla Wafer Chevrolet. Been on a terrible streak as of late. But since this is a super speedway, let's hope this is what he needs.
John Paolucci in the Jasper Infants Ford alongside Michigan winner Elijah Gordon. Toby Bell in the Tide Pontiac.
We'll start alongside Leah Sutton in the Cat Truck Engines Dodge.
Pocono winner.
Yep, Pocono winner.
We have our Las Vegas winner, Javier Hernandez in the Bug King of Beers Chevrolet alongside our last Super Speedway winner, Landon Martin in the FedEx Express Ford.
Jordan Anderson will be in the Jasper Engines Ford alongside Dominique Anthony in the UAW Delphi Chevrolet.
Jordan Bell in the Oreo Chevrolet and Aiden Shepard in the USA Army Pontiac. We have Eric Keaton in the Irwin Industrial Tools Ford
making its first start alongside Tyson Gifford driving the Cheez-It Pontiac.
We have
Colin McGovern returning to the Rent-A-Center Ford alongside Ken Bell in the Stacker 2 Dodge.
We have Richard Kinghart in the Valvoline Pontiac and Ryan Kesey in the Mountain Dew Code Red Chevrolet. We have Daniel Royals in the Georgia-Pacific Dodge and Tyler Deaver puts the rainbow colors back in the race for this race.
Morgan Grimpler will be driving the X-Side Battery Ford alongside Matthew Crash in the Mountain Dew Dodge.
We have Eli Bright in the Pennzoil Synthetic Chevrolet alongside Hayden Caldwell busting out the Kodak Easy Share Dodge.
Miller Lite Dodge. By the way, Eli Bright just, at this point, he's just busting out anything, just hoping he can survive. Then we have Zachary Fitzwater in the All-Tel Ford. California winner alongside Sean McKean in the Pendleville National Guard Ford.
Who, even though he had a DNF, finished 19th officially last week.
Benna Williams will be in the Dr. Pepper Chevrolet, and rounding out the field is Ignis Kirksey in the Aaron's Chevrolet. We keep forgetting to mention the name of the race at the beginning. This is the Aaron's 499 at Talladega. And that's why Ignis Kirksey is in that car. Tyler, we got 20 seconds left before the command is given. What's going to be key here?
Just staying near the front. You just got to stay near the front. And just pray that you avoid the big one.
And if it's anything like the last race, pit stops are going to matter at Daytona.
Oh, yeah.
Drivers, start your engines.
The command is given. Willie Boulderquake will lead them to the line.
So he will join the illustrious group who will be in season 2's Bloodlines or Shootout. By qualifying on the pole.
Willie Boulderquake. Where was it he finished? Well, Pocono, but then he got caught up in... No, wasn't he still running at Texas, even though he was, like, a lap down?
Yeah.
Yeah, Willie Boulderquake hoping to...
Turns him a little look around. He's got his teammate behind him.
But... At this race, Tyler, I don't think teammates matter. When it's go time, it's go time.
Well, your teammates matter in the first part of the race. If I'm a couple teammates close together, if I see a couple of my teammates, I want to ask, hey, let's hook up, let's stay together.
And then the one behind you shoves you in the high lane.
As here we go, boogity, 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 let's go racing, boys!
At Talledega!
Oh, man.
Let's see how long it takes me. No one's gonna get a good start. But as you can see, that bottom line with Willie Boulderquake is gonna easily catch back up.
Well, those two Fords have got a Ford's got some power.
I'm watching that third row, Jonathan King and Betty Williams. Johnson, excuse me, Betty Johnson. Willie Boulderquake gonna pull out in front.
Zach McVay gonna go to the wide there. Oh, Jonathan King in the middle. Here comes Josh Richards.
Willie Boulderquake officially leads lap one. Alright, look who's right behind Jonathan King.
Oh man. How would you like it if you're one of those two?
Resisting the urge to put the other one in the wall. Oh! Battle for the lead!
Harry! Here comes Quentin Moore, who finished second at Daytona!
And John Gambit!
Who won the shootout.
The three great cars!
Talk to John Gambit! This is the same car they won at the shoot. They won the shootout with.
But it got lost. But also got destroyed in the 500.
Well, that was a different.
No, wasn't it? The only person that doesn't have their car right now is Zach McVay because he had to put his in Daytona USA.
Well, I'm sure he's using his Coca-Cola car.
Good point.
Or a brand new race car.
That also could be true as. Last week's winner, Matthew Medev, looking on the inside of Perry.
Here comes Paolucci, he finished, what, third?
Yeah, he was third, because Kinghart got around him. David Perry, looking strong.
Here comes Toby Bell.
Leading that bottom lane.
Oh, man. Javier Hernandez, who finished in the top five last week at Texas.
Oh, that T is just wrong name. Take a look at our Aaron's car to figure out where Ignis Kirksey is. He is in the middle. Let's go on board Ignis Kirksey. Just show you what it's like here at Talladega. Toby Bell is now leading.
No, here comes Jordan Anderson.
Yeah, Jordan Anderson going for... Who did I hit? Oh, no.
Three wide. Jordan Bell.
Jordan Bell to the lead.
Just finished this season second at Las Vegas. Has not been able to capitalize on that second.
He's going to lead the lap. Colin McGovern also.
Daniel Voiles. How about the bottom row? All these cars really need a good run this week.
Oh yeah.
Here comes Colin McGovern.
McGovern to the lead.
Here comes our Coca-Cola winner.
Landon Martin. Look who's also down there. Zachary Fitzwater. The Williams. Looking for her first win.
Matthew Crash.
Colin McGovern leads the lap.
And we're going to... No, you won't... That you'll see now, but you won't see later.
Mm-hmm. Probably. Knowing this track.
I mean, just in a second ago, we were talking about John Gambit, and look how far he's gotten. Here comes Daniel Voiles, bringing Grumpler to the bottom.
Daniel Voiles looking for the lead. I think he's got it. But Grumpler, he was thinking about it.
Here comes Fitzwater.
Oh, Benna. Gonna go into the lane. Nope, she's fine. Looks like people won't. The only time people can make it past is going into turn two. Unless you're Venna Williams and you're deciding now it's the time to go, but.
Here comes Morgan Griffler.
Venna Williams. Gonna go to the inside of Fitzwater as the camera crew screwed that one up again. Morgan Griffler to the lead.
Here comes Benna. Ryan Kesey.
Yeah, another car that needs a good run. And Matthew Crash is now going in the middle. So is Jordan Bell. In the sucker hole, as we call it. But there's a gap. There was a gap between the bottom lane, but then Boyles decided to get on in there.
Here comes Venna.
Venna Williams. Cameras. Now let's see how far back Morgan Grimpler is going to fall back. And Boyles was able to get back to the bottom, as you can see him in third place.
Oh, man.
And look who's right there in the bottom, behind Caldwell.
Ignis Kirksey, the Aaron's car, the Aaron's dream machine.
Benna Williams. Looking for her first win.
All these people except for Hayden.
Well, Zach McVay's right there too.
And Leah Sutton.
Yeah, and Leah Sutton. Ryan Keith going for the lead. And Ignis Kirksey moves Boyles to the outside lane.
Here comes Zach McVay, the Daytona 500 winner. You have to mention him at a restrictor plate.
Look at Leah Sutton.
Well, she did. She did have a good car in Daytona, remember?
Yeah, she did run top five.
She was actually leading the Daytona 500 for more. I think she was one of the cars that... She had one of the better cars at Daytona. They brought the same car back. They brought the Daytona car here for Talladega.
And now Zach McVay is looking for third. Alec Bossinger in fourth. Ryan Keith might be the first car to lead more than one lap. Let's see if Leah Sutton can get anything going into the tri-oval.
Here comes that 24.
Where's he at?
He's behind the 16.
Talledega in the Rainbow Warrior Chevrolet.
Now we got single file up here.
Brian Keith.
As I say that.
Yeah, as soon as you say that, Zachary Bay is gonna go, but nothing for Keith as he continues to hold the lead.
How about that 00?
Tyson Gifford. Betty Johnson, she's up there, not alongside Jonathan King.
Behind Tyler Deaver. Like we said, we haven't talked about these cars. McKean.
McVay as of late.
Here comes
Keith.
Yeah. So, and Kesey might have the best car out front.
Let's see what McVay decides to do here.
McVay's gonna...
McVay and Gifford are going for it. McKean goes up high. Rainbow is in third.
Zach McVay. This is a familiar sight.
Oh yeah. But now Tyson Gifford. He needs a good run. And then you got Ken Bell in the back. Tyson Gifford going for the lead.
Comes Ken Bell along with Eric Eaton.
Eric Eaton definitely needing a good run in that Irwin Ford. Eli Bright was in the middle there, but he gets to the bottom. And
Ken Bell's in the
middle now. Eaton putting Ken Bell in the middle.
In the trial.
Eaton can do that on normal cars. If he's up in the front, expect him to go crazy around two to go. Tyler Deaver and teammate Dominique Anthony.
Along with Josh Richards and another Hendrick car.
Yeah, three Hendrick cars on that bottom lane. So 24, 25, 18, 00, and 48. Tyler racing Jeff Gordon's famous Rainbow Warriors today.
Race those at Daytona as well, and Richard.
Yeah, Josh Richards. That's the Hendrick cars are all going high. But Tyler's blocking Josh Richard.
How about that one car?
Eli Bright in fourth place. Well, sadly, he's racing for four. And Josh Richard to the bottom! If this was the last lap... Oh, man.
Still got a long way to go.
Josh Richard racing the whole car this week. And Aiden Shepherd. Another car that needs a good run this week.
Here comes the three car.
Oh yeah. Earnhardt always knew how to race at restricted plate, but Cole friggin' quit after getting flipping at Daytona.
Here comes the nine.
Three wide, hold that line. Michael Gregory in second. And Cole Deaver's going past Javier Hernandez for third. Look who's fifth on the bottom.
Landon Martin?
Yep. Look at Cole! Oh, Harry you can see this is definitive restrictor plate racing, and Cole Deaver goes to the bottom.
Who's going to lead the lap here at Talladega? Richards, I believe, will lead.
No!
Richards!
By how much? Oh! That would have been one heck of a finish. And look who's third on the bottom. Look at that whole bottom line! As Cole goes to his favorite lane on any racetrack.
Landon Martin, how about those three Fords right there? Manufacturers working together.
Yeah, you're right. Oh, look who, and then you got fourth and fifth on the bottom. Benna came back, and Quentin Moore, a Daytona 500 favorite, that Gambit's gonna put Jordan Anderson in the sucker hole. Senna Williams now moving past Gambit.
This is, by the way, at 11th, this is not the same car that they won with Coca-Cola. It's a different car. It's actually a brand new race car.
As Sean McKean goes to the lead. Along with Senna Williams and Quentin Moore, and then there's fourth place Jonathan King.
And Zachary Fitzwater.
Denna Williams.
Let's check up on our pole sitter.
Willie Boulderquake? Yeah, let's take a look and see what happened to him. Oh, he's on the bottom. Go on board and see what it's like to be back here. Etta Williams leads. Zachary. Tommy Keane, Ken Bell, Jonathan King, and Hayden Caldwell. Fitzwater to the lead. All by himself. Oh, Dominic Gandy's gonna go under. Zachary Fitzwater definitely trying to improve as of late. Oh! Ken Bell gonna shove Caldwell up, but Caldwell keeps it on bottom.
How long? Come on, how long do you do? How long does it take for someone to get back to the front? That's what a lot of these drivers are trying to figure out. How long does it take me to get back to the front?
Yeah. And plus, there are other factors, like, can I get back to the bottom? Like what Cole Deaver has done. If you look way far back there in the back, Cole Deaver was about middle of the pack when we checked on Willie Boulderquake. He's now on the bottom.
In front of Willie.
Yeah. Hey, Willie might let him in. Maybe those two are trying to work together. Single file as Zachary Fitzwater leads.
Well, we got two teammates. Well, never mind. The teammates decided to go their separate ways.
So you just had to say something, didn't you?
Yeah.
We are officially halfway through the race, by the way. Lap 24 out of 47.
Here comes Ken Bell.
Ken Bell, I don't think it's going to be enough to get the Fitzwater. And look who's right behind Ken Bell.
Jordan Bell. Eli Bright.
Old Eva and pole sitter Willie Boulderquake.
And Toby Bell.
Toby Bell as well. The only Bell that's not up there is Nate Bell. He's way in the back. Fitzwater leads another lap.
I think Fitzwater's been one of the only cars to really lead.
The only two cars that can lead, that have been able to lead laps and stay up front, have been Fitzwater, Keith, and I think Benoit. Alright. Ken Bell going for the lead. And so is Eli Bright and Cole Deaver following. Where was it that Ken Bell got his best finish? Wasn't it Ontario?
Yeah, finished second at Ontario.
Oh, Eli Bright! Okay, kept it in line. Let's go back to Boyle, because I think we might have had a three, almost four wide situation. It calmed down now. Let's go back to, I believe it was Toby Bell, or Ken Bell. Yep, Ken Bell along with Eli Bright. Cole and Eli.
Here comes that one car. That one car desperately needs the good run.
Now he just... But is it too soon to go? Because once you fall back, you gotta work your way all the way back up.
Well, if I'm Eli Bright at this point, I'm happy just to be leading.
And three wide back here, between Paolucci, between Jerry Paolucci, Toby Bell, and Ken Bell. As we go back to the leaders. Cole Deaver. And Jerry Paolucci. They're going for it.
Here comes Eric Eaton. Betty Johnson.
Whoa.
Shove the heat.
Three wide situation for third again. And look who's coming back. That 24 rainbow car.
Here comes the 43 though.
Yep, here comes Jerry Paolucci, the M&M's Ford, with Betty Johnson in tow. I like how the relatives are always near each other. Like, you had three Bells near each other, and the Paoluccis are near each other. And the Deaver brothers.
Here they come.
Jerry Paolucci to lead his first lap.
Let's just hope he doesn't be upside down at Talladega.
Yeah, that car has a habit. Zach McVay's working his way back up there.
But is it too soon for that car?
Too many factors so far. Betty Johnson. And Eric Keaton, who got back to the bottom after being in a three-wide situation not too long ago. Eddie Johnson looking to take at being upsetted twice.
Very frustrated. She thought she had the car to win at Pocono in Texas.
And then Jonathan called Jonathan King happened.
Yeah. Team laps to go at Talladega. Who wins?
Eric Eaton down low. Ignis Kirksey in tow, along with Zach McVay, Morgan Grimpler, and Gabriel Wanderlei. Three wide in the back of the pack. And now Zach McVay moves Ignis Kirksey up into the middle. Very key.
That's really going to hurt the 43 and 24.
Yep. will McVay do this lap? Grimpler.
That's Eaton's teammate.
Yep, Eaton's gonna hook up with Grimpler.
3 Fords and 2 Pontiacs on the bottom.
That Raymond Chevrolet up high.
Here comes Daniel Voiles.
Voiles is making his way. Grimpler down low. Gifford going with them. Aiden Shepherd,
Daniel Voile, Leah Sutton. And will pit stops play a factor?
More than likely. And look who's finally coming up. What in right behind the 18 car, Nate Bell.
Grimpler lead.
Grimpler lead. And let's go on board Nate Bell's car.
Here comes Boyles.
Right hip for lead. Boyle.
There's Gambit.
Where's he at? Oh yeah, he's on the bottom. Cruz, work with me here.
McVay got back to the bottom.
Boyles to the lead.
Here comes Josh Richards. Gonna make it 3 wide.
Oh man, Richard did making it 3 wide.
The teammate decided to abandon him. Pit stops at Talladega.
Pit stops are happening. Who's coming in first? Richards, Gordon,
Gambit,
Martin, Keith, Wanderlei. A whole bunch of cars coming in.
That really messed up the field.
Who was leading?
Boyles.
And Nate Bell goes for the lead.
You see, look at the distance between Tyson Gifford and Leah Sutton. Now if Boyles wants to pit, he can't.
Boyles is staying out. Gifford.
Who's staying out? Who's pitting this lap?
Oh, I didn't want to do that. Nate Bell, Quentin Moore, Leah Sutton, Aiden Shepherd, Paolucci, Bossinger, Martins, Medev, Toby Bell,
Betty Johnson,
Tyson Gifford.
Tyson Gifford was in that little
Heaton. Morgan Grimpler, Heaton.
Crash.
Crash. Who's in 21? Colin McGovern,
yeah.
Medev. Cameron Cruz, Elijah Gordon. Wait, this is the first pack.
Yeah, that pitted.
Now Boyles is on pit road. So is Cole Deaver, Zach McVay, Johnson King,
Michael Gregory,
Venna Williams, Jerry Paolucci, Willie Boulderquake, Ignis Kirksey, Eli Bright, Jordan Bell, Tyler Deaver, Dominic Anthony, David Perry, Richard Kinghart. And then you got these guys coming off of pit road.
Who has scored as the leader?
It's Boyles, remember? Let's find Boyles.
It just came off a pit road.
Boyles is still leader!
But where's that next group of cars at, Cole?
We're about to find out.
Where's the 20 at? He was with that next group that...
I think I hear them. Yep, here they are!
Here they come!
Boyles is gonna be in front of them! No, he's gonna hold up Elijah Gordon!
He's trying to get back up to speed, remember?
Yeah, but he's gonna... I think he's gonna be fine! Now, where's the next pack? So, they got a ways to go!
And then there's a little pack right behind them!
Perry definitely got the worst of it. So did Kinghart. All these cars! The only thing that's gonna save them is a caution! I honestly think, with 10 to go, it might come down to this pack.
With Nate Bell out in front.
Quentin Moore in second.
We have four Pontiacs up here. Remember, Pontiac has not won yet.
Man, that'd be a one heck of a way to win.
Remember, who finished second at Daytona?
Quentin Moore.
Exactly.
You still got other people looking for their first win, like Ryan Keith, Josh Richard, Landon Martin.
Well, Landon Martin won at Coca-Cola.
I mean, yeah.
Sean McKean, Daniel Voiles, Tyson Gifford.
Going on the inside of Quentin Moore. Ryan Keith, Landon Martin, Josh Richard. This is going to be one heck of a race.
Unless the caution comes out.
Like it did at Daytona. And remember, there was a second pack at Daytona. And it took them a while, but they caught them.
But I don't think they have the laps that that pack did.
This is Talladega.
Yeah.
Anything could happen if Tyson Gifford goes for the lead. Yeah, Perry. I think Perry got the worst of it.
Wait, there's only 41 cars.
Four seconds. Oh, it is Perry. Okay. Ryan Keith! Going for the lead! Landon Martin trying to go two for three in Super Speedway. Wasn't McVay in that second pack?
Mm-hmm.
He was in the second pack at Daytona.
But they didn't have the pack back there doesn't have this. They don't have time, really, because we have, what, 7 to go?
7 to go right now. If the second pack wants to do anything, they need to get single file right now.
Or a caution comes out.
Which I doubt is going to happen. Because as much green flag, 3-wide racing we've been here, and no cautions come out yet. I doubt it. That's Landon Martin going for the lead. Back. Let's go back. There they are. Yeah, that's what they have to do right now is get single file and try and chase that pack down. See, they're running 199. They're running fast. Okay, they're running, sure, at 1 mile an hour, but that's not going to be much.
Sean McKean,
go for the lead. Nate Bell in second.
Daniel Boyles.
Looking for his first win. Pretty much everyone in that pack except for Martin.
The two cars on the outside.
Landon Martin and Elijah Gordon, those are the only Those are the only two cars in that pack that have won a race. Dang, Shepard on the bottom.
Yeah, the Pontiacs have formed up again, but with a Dodge in the middle, but stuck between them.
Yeah.
The only Dodge in this group.
Yeah, you're right.
So if Dodge wants to win at Talladega,
they're going to have to rely on Boyles. But Boyles is going for it. Camera crews.
And remember, next week, the All-Star Race.
Yeah.
Win, and you're in the All-Star Race.
Yeah, this is true. We're going to have people want to get in that All-Star Race. I don't think, yeah, it looks like this pack is going to just, cars. Old Deaver now leads this pack. It's basically a 10-car breakaway right now. Aiden Shepherd to the lead.
He's bringing the Coca-Cola winner with him.
Three wide in the back there. Sean McKean goes to the bottom. Nate Bell.
Boyles leads the lap. But does it matter?
At this point, I don't think it does. All of these cars are in great position right now. Aiden Shepherd looking for base. I think all these cars right here might be in great position. Two laps to go for Aiden Shepherd.
Can he hold off the Coca-Cola winner?
Can he hold off Ryan Keith, Nate Bell?
Sean McKean, don't forget about that Ford. The only Ford in this group, besides Landon Martin.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to catch him.
Coming to take the white flag. Here comes Landon Martin. He's going to make his move now.
Crunch time for Landon Martin. Bringing along Nate Bell and Sean McKean. Quentin Moore is also there. He got second at Daytona.
Well, Landon Martin.
And remember, the last two Super Speedways have ended under caution. This is going to be the first
white flag at Talladega.
This is going to be the first time we ever finish a Super Speedway race.
Is it going to be Nate Bell, Sean McKean, or Landon Martin? Those are the three I think that have a shot at it.
John McKean!
McKean to the bottom! Don't think he's got enough!
He's gonna have to do it in the tri-oval.
Orlando Martin's gonna go back-to-back in restrictor plates. Here they come to the checkered flag! Who's gonna win it at Talladega? It will be Landon Martin wins the Aaron's 499!
Two for two. Well, two for three. What a race. We finally got our first ever restrictor plate green flag finish. And congratulations to Landon Martin in the FedEx Ford. Grabbing his second win of the season, becoming the second repeat winner of the year.
But will this point? Will these points?
Alright, let's run down the field. First place, Landon Martin. Second place, Sean McKean. Third place, Quentin Moore. Third place, Quentin Moore. Fourth place, Elijah Gordon. Fifth, Nate Bell. Sixth, Tyson Gifford, 7th, Aiden Shepherd, 8th, Josh Richard, 9th, Ryan Keith, and rounding out the first pack with Daniel Boyles in 10th.
11th, Leah Sutton, 12th, Colin McGovern, 13th, Zachary Fitzwater, 14th, Eric Keaton, 15th, Ken Bell, 16th, Morgan Grimpler, 17th, Javier Hernandez, 18th, Zach McVay, 19th, Kyle Martins, 20th, John Paolucci, 21st, Gabriel Wanderley, 22nd, Alex Bossinger, 23rd, Cole Deaver, 24th, Jordan Anderson, 25th, John Gambit, 26th, Toby Bell, 27th, Jerry Paolucci, 28th, Hayden Caldwell, 29th, Matthew Medav, 30th, Jonathan King, 31st, Matthew Crash, 32nd, Vinnell Williams, 33rd, Betty Johnson, 34th, Dominic Anthony, 35th, Eli Bright, 36th, Jordan Bell, 37th, pole sitter Willie Boulderquake, 38th, Tyler Deaver, 39th, Ignis Kirksey, 40th, Michael Gregory, 41st, Richard Kinghart, and riding out the field will be David Perry.
Well, we had a good, decent race today.
Good, clean, safe race. That's all we can ask for. And Landon Martin,
second win and second in the restrictor plates. Well, this has been the Aaron's 499 and the production of the NASCAR Wheaties Cup.
This has been Tyler Deaver.
And this has been Dragon Knight Cole. And we will see you next week. No points are on the line.
Just $1 million.
As they get ready for the All-Star Race. We'll see you then.